Covered by moist sediment, weathering is prevented, and for these reasons, quick burial is perhaps the most important condition favoring fossilization. Quick burial.
That's right, Dr. Vyth. Quick burial favors fossilization. It's not crucial, it's not absolutely necessary, it simply favors fossilization.
Claire, you anti-science, anti-geology, anti-paleontology, evolutionist, uniformitarianist, you. You've taken what Dr. Vyth has said completely out of context. What he is saying is that the chances are better that you will get a fossil, not that a fossil is possible. You're taking what he says out of context. He is not stating that fossilization can occur over long, if the strata that it is buried in were laid down over long depositions like uniformitarian tards believe. What he's saying is the chances that you can get a fossil, period, are better if the creature is rapidly buried. It is not possible, Claire, for a creature to be buried over vast amounts of time by slow deposition that the uniformitarian tards believe in, for in it become a fossil. It cannot happen, Claire. If an elephant fell dead in India somewhere, out in the open where the sun is and there's trees and whatnot, and the thing fell dead and laid on the ground for 2,000 years, and you came back in 2,000 years, you know what you'd find? Nothing, Claire. Not even bone. Nothing. It is not possible for a creature to become fossilized if it is not rapidly buried and its bones are sealed away from the oxygen and the solar radiation which decays it. You want to know what the sun does to things, Claire? Have you ever seen an old automobile, the vinyl of which has been eaten away and the paint has come off of it because it's been sitting in a lot abandoned for 35 years? What do you think the sun is going to do to organic material, Claire? If it can eat steel, what's it going to do to bone? If it can eat steel and cause rust and eat the paint off of something and cause plastic to dry out and become dust in a couple of decades, what is it going to do to bones over a period of 2,000 years? It's going to destroy it, Claire. You see, evolutionists like yourself have to cling to your worldview, which requires that you believe that the strata of the earth were laid down over vast amounts of time. And therefore, because you believe that, you have to cling to that, because you must deny the flood, and you must deny young earth creation, because you must deny creation, because you must deny God. You see, you have to believe that creatures are buried over vast amounts of time, and this is what has created the fossil record. But it is impossible, Claire. It is impossible for a creature to be preserved so that it can be a fossil. It must be buried rapidly. That means very quickly, Claire, else there'll be nothing left. If an elephant dies and falls to the ground, there'll be nothing left of it in 2,000 years, not even bone. The only reason bones don't decay into dust inside the earth is because they're sealed off from aerobic bacteria and the sun. I'm going to show you something. What you're looking at here is an article written by this person. This person has a degree in archaeology, has an MSc in osteology, paleopathology, funerary archaeology. This person is professionally educated in the science of how creatures decay in the earth. Do you understand that? They have several degrees, okay? This is an article from their site. It states, and I want to show you something. If you'll read this article, Claire, you'll find all kinds of discussion about how bones decay. This article is about medieval people, Anglo-Saxons, recovered from graves in Europe. Okay? I want to show you something very funny here. This author states, there is little standardization in the archaeological literature concerning levels of preservation, so this analysis dependent on comments by the excavators osteologists working with the bones regarding the level of preservation, which is at best vague and subjective. You know why this is, Claire? What this person is saying, the evolutionists that perform these kinds of science don't like discussing exact data about how long it takes for bone to decay into nothing in the earth, because it refutes their claims about the fossil record. If you read this, and if you have the level of intelligence or understanding that a lot of other people do, such as myself, you read this statement, there is little standardization in the archaeological literature concerning levels of preservation. So this analysis is dependent on comments by the excavators and osteologists working with the bones regarding the level of preservation, which is at best vague and subjective. You see, Claire, evolutionist tards don't like to write articles that refute uniformitarianism. And that's why there is very little standardization in the archaeological literature about how rapidly bones decay in the earth. Because they don't want you to know. They don't want it to become a part of science. And why? Because it refutes the garbage that you're talking about. That a creature can be buried over thousands and thousands and thousands of years and turn into a fossil, because they know there would be nothing left of it. Now, what this article is discussing is creatures, human beings, which were buried in the earth. They're not talking about animals that died and were left on the ground to be covered in your imaginary thousands and thousands of years of slow deposition, because such creature, in such case as that, if that were the case, there would be nothing left at all. What they're talking about is the decay rate of bones that are buried in the earth and preserved away from oxygen and solar radiation. And here's what they say. These are descriptions of the level of decay of the bones in various sites ranging from the 5th through the 7th centuries AD. This one was moderate. This one, decomposed. What does that mean? Nothing remained except an impression. Very poor, good to excellent. Well, sometimes they can be well preserved. For 2,000 years, Claire. No, actually for what, 1,400 or 1,500 years? Not for 25,000 years, Claire. This one was fair preserved. But not all the bone curated, which means they only had some bones, and those that were preserved were fairly preserved. The rest of it decayed into nothing. In 1,500 years, Claire, this one was well preserved. This one ranged from poor to good. This one was excellent. This one was rather poor. This one was good preservation. This one was very poor. Bone only present in 32% of the graves. Most of it was gone. Most of those skeletons did not survive. In the earth, Claire. Not on the surface of the ground where the sun is destroying it like it does a car over a period of 30 years. No, inside the earth where it's preserved, sealed away from oxygen and the sun and scavengers. Oh, by the way, in this article, he describes how scavengers strewn the bones of many of these finds. They were all over the place. In some cases, they only found a few bones from a human being because of scavengers. Now what's going to happen? Varied preservation. This one says mostly poor condition. Varied from poor to good. Most bones destroyed. Varied, but generally poor. Good to none exist. Fair preservation. Generally poor. Generally, bone generally survived well. Fairly good. Particularly good. Reasonable preservation. Reasonable to very good. Reasonable to very good. Some of these are decayed tremendously, Claire. Now, I understand that the acidity, the type of environment they're found in, but this is common. No matter where you dig up an animal that has been dead for 1,000 or 2,000 years, this is the kind of decay you're going to find for its bones. Claire, guess it hasn't rung a bell with you. The hominids that you evotards call ancestors of man are not ancestors of man. They're extinct apes, and they've only been dead since the flood. Because if they were buried over vast amounts of time, they wouldn't exist at all. And if they were buried and did not and fossilized, it could only be that they died within the last few thousand years, because if not, there would be no bones left. If these human skeletons can decay to relatively poor and sometimes gone in 2,000 years, Claire, less than 2,000 years, what do you think is going to happen to a skeleton buried in 5 or 6 feet of earth over a period of 50,000 years? Claire, you evotards think these bones are millions of years old. Millions! You've got to be out of your mind. Claire, here's some interesting statements by this author. He says, acidic draining soils such as sand and or gravel result in bad archaeological preservation of bone. This may be so extreme that human remains are only detectable as shadows in the sand. Shadows. Claire, do you know we have thousands and thousands of fossils of creatures that were buried in sand? You stated in one of your previous videos that creatures can be buried in sand that we find in sandstone are fossilized over vast amounts of time and in aeolian sand beds, dry sand. Claire, how ludicrous and non-scientific you are. How anti-science you are. It is not possible for a creature to be buried in dry sand and it become a fossil. Even when it's buried in wet sand, it often doesn't survive. So how is the fossil record so rife with creatures that were buried in sand? And we have dinosaurs and fish fossils by the boodles in sandstone, Claire. Why? Because they were rapidly buried in an environment which was filled with the right minerals because there was a flood, Claire. Also, he states, indeed, modern experiments on decay using pigs have been hampered by foxes and dogs disturbing the remains. Carnivores and small burrowing animals may remove or disturb bone or destroy it by gnawing, blah, 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 etc. You see, they don't survive, even if scavengers don't survive. Claire, if an elephant fell to the ground in India and lay there for 2,000 years and you think it takes 10, 15,000 or 47,000 or 111,000 or 290,000 years for the thing to get buried so that it can become a fossil, how absurd it is. Do you think there'd be anything left after scavengers left it, got a hold of it? Probably not. Probably not anything. And if there was, it would have been decayed into dust in less than 3,000 years, Claire. If it's laying out on open ground. It cannot happen, Claire. It's impossible for an organism to be buried over vast amounts of time, over your evotard long deposition, and for it to become a fossil. It is not science to think that way, Claire. Here's a study, Claire, where they buried fish and came back years later to see what happened to them. Oftentimes the fish bones didn't survive at all. Claire, do you know what you're looking at? That's a fossilized human finger. That's right, Claire. It's a human finger. It's a fossil. You know what this is, Claire? That's a human leg fossilized inside a boot that was manufactured in the 1950s. How long did it take to fossilize, Claire? You know what this is? That's a handprint from a human being in Cretaceous stone. Now, Claire, you don't believe human beings lived many millions of years ago, do you? Obviously not. And, Claire, that's a tree, a polystrate tree, passing through dozens and dozens and dozens of strata. Do you really believe that the top part of that tree survived for millions and millions of years standing upright, Claire? Or even 150,000 years, Claire, before rotting and falling to the ground? Do you think it survived for 3,000 years dead standing up while it was slowly, slowly buried